Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's take a look at using shortcuts automation. So a new feature in the shortcuts app in macOS Tahoe is the ability to add automation. This means that you could have shortcuts that are triggered by actions or events. The way to set this up is to go to the shortcuts app. Then look in the left sidebar here for automation. You can go there and create an automation using the plus button at the top right. You could also just go to File and New Automation. So the first thing you need to do is set the trigger for this shortcut. So there's a lot of them here. For instance, the easiest one to understand is time of day. Select that, go to Next, and you see you could set it for a specific time of day or sunrise or sunset. You could have it repeat daily, weekly, or monthly. If you choose like weekly, you could choose the days of the week here, or monthly, you could have it starting on a certain day of the month. You could also have it triggered when an alarm from the clock app goes off. If you look here, you can have it when it goes off, when you snooze it, or when you stop the alarm. And you could choose the alarm by name. So you'd have a specific alarm that triggers an automation, and then you could change that alarm and turn it on and turn it off as you like. But there are also a lot of events here that could happen that could trigger an automation. For instance, when you get an email or a message from a specific person with text in the subject, something in a folder changes, when something in a file changes, when you connect or disconnect an external drive. Also, when Wi-Fi is connected or disconnected, and the same for a Bluetooth device. You can also have an event triggered when a display is connected or disconnects, when Stage Manager is turned on or off, when an app is launched or quit. And you can also have it triggered when you simply turn on or off a focus mode. So for instance, do not disturb, you can have that when it's turned on, when it's turned off, both, and have the actions run then. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MacMost at Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You could read about it at macmost.com/Patreon. So as a very simple example, let's use the app trigger here. And let's say that when a certain app, let's choose it here, and I'm going to search for it, and I'm going to say Keynote. When Keynote is opened, then run after confirmation, not immediately, but you'll get a notification, and you can choose to run it or not. And then what we're going to have happen is when Keynote is opened, we're going to create a new shortcut here with this button, like that. And then we're going to add some actions to it. One of the things I want to have happen when I launch Keynote is I want some apps quit so they're not running and I don't accidentally switch to them while I'm giving a presentation. So I'm going to look for app here, and then I'm going to choose quit app. And the app I'm going to choose in this case is mail. And I'm going to add that. I'm going to add another one, quit app, and choose messages, and have that one quit as well. And then also, when I start a presentation, I sometimes forget to set the focus mode to do not disturb. So I'm going to search for focus here and say set focus to turn, and I'll use do not disturb, but I could use another focus mode if I want. Turn it on, and then I can set it to until it turned off, or a specific time, or try leave this location, or ask each time which one I want. So I'll actually do ask each time, and then I'll close it here. Now notice I've got messages in mail running, and also notice I'm not using any particular focus mode right now, but I'm going to launch Keynote. And when I do, you could see I get this notification here asking me if I want to run this shortcut. Yes, I do. And I then get prompted because remember I had it ask me when I want to turn off the do not disturb mode. So I'll say, do it until I turn it off. Done. Notice that messages and mail quit, and now I have Do Not Disturb turned on. So now I have a handy way to set up my Mac when I'm about to give a presentation. If I was just working on the presentation, I could have chosen not to run it, but just dismiss the notification instead. Now let's go back into Shortcuts and see how you edit this. If you go to Automation here, you'll see it, and you can select it. And if you double click, it will take you into the shortcut itself. So I can now change which apps are quit. Maybe I can remove one of these, or add another quit or some other action. If you need to change the automation trigger itself, then instead of double-clicking here, control-click, right-click, or two-finger click on a trackpad here, and then go to Edit Automation. And now you can change which app this is triggered by, or maybe change it from Run After Confirmation to just Run Immediately. Let's look at some other examples. So I'll start a new automation here, and I'll go down to these focus modes. Let's say that when I turn on my studying focus mode, I wanted to do certain things and just run it immediately like that. And it gives me some suggestions here. For instance, set volume. I'll take that first suggestion and I'll use it. And it's going to start a new shortcut here and it's going to have that action in there. Let's go and say, no, I want it to go all the way down to 10%. And then in addition to that, maybe I can also have it quit an app like maybe Safari. Then I could add whatever else I want here. Now this will trigger when I switch to the studying focus mode. I've got my sound, let's set it halfway like that, and I've got Safari running here. So if I go and switch to studying, you could see Safari quits, and then if I check the volume, you could see the volume's automatically been set to 10%. Now, if you're on a MacBook, you may notice there are more triggers, and that's because you've got a battery, and you can connect and disconnect power to your MacBook, something you can't do on my Mac Studio. So here on a MacBook, if I go and set up an automation, you could see I've got battery level and I can have something triggered when it reaches a specific battery level, rises above, falls below, and so on. I also can set it for when the charger connects or is disconnected. Common problem you run into, for instance, is sometimes with MagSafe, you accidentally disconnect the charger and then you don't realize it, but your MacBook is now losing power. So you can set it up like this, that when the power is disconnected, run immediately. And we'll take this first suggestion right here and have it speak text. This is a handy little action because you can have it say whatever you want. So you could say, you know, power disconnected. You can click here and then you could turn off, wait until finished. You don't need the shortcut to pause. You just need it to just send that text to audio. And then you could do rate, pitch, language, and set it to the voice. So I've got a lot of voices here, but I'm going to use the Siri voice right here. So now if I pull the MagSafe cord off of my MacBook, it will run.
Power disconnected.
Here's another example that involves receiving a message. So when you use this, you can set a sender or just leave it blank for any sender. Then I'm going to have it when it contains something in the text. So just a bit of text like that, have it run immediately. And then I'm just going to have it do kind of the same thing as before, adding a speak action here. So speak text. And I just wanted to speak the actual message out loud. So the way to do that is here where you have text, I'm going to control click, two finger click, or right click. Insert shortcut input. Shortcut input is an object. It's this message object. You want to get a specific piece of information from the message. To do that, what you need to do is make sure you've deselected the text there. So select something else. So if not selected, then double click here. And then you get this shortcut input selector here. What I wanted to use here is the content of the message. So now when I choose that, you can see this changes to content. And you can see now I could set the voice and all of that. I'll turn off wait until finished. And now let's test it out. Notice I don't have the messages app running. So let's get this message sent from a different account and the message will come and we should speak this particular message because the words good news appear in the content.
Good news, everyone.
So the idea here is maybe you get text messages from some sort of automated system, like maybe you sell products on some sort of online marketplace and get a text message every time you make a sale. You could have this triggered by text that's always in those messages. And let's take a look at one more example. This one I'm going to have triggered when a folder changes contents. Which folder? Well, let's choose the downloads folder. And when the contents of the downloads folder change, because a file is added to it, then we're going to run something immediately. And what are we going to run? Well, we're going to create a new shortcut here, and you can see it receives the folder change summary as input. So we can use this data for something, like for instance, figuring out what file was just added to the downloads folder and then do something with it. So here's my downloads folder. It's empty right now, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a new folder inside the downloads folder called PDFs. And the idea is that whenever a PDF is added to the downloads folder, because I downloaded it, say, in Safari, it is moved into this PDFs folder in here. This PDFs folder could be in your documents folder or somewhere else. I'm just going to put it in the downloads folder so we can see it easily, and it acts kind of as organization for the downloads folder. So let's go and get the folder input, which should be the file that was added, and look for an action to move that file. And here it is. So I can double click on it and it says move the file to what? So first let's set what file to move. I'm going to not click here because it's going to ask me to specify a file. Instead, I'm going to control click, right click, or two finger click and change this to shortcut input. But remember, shortcut input is an object. So what we want to do here is click it once and then look and see here that the object is actually the folder change summary, information about what's been changed. Instead, let's go and select added files. So this should be a list of added files, but this gives us a clue that there might be more than one. So what we're going to do is we're going to escape out of that and delete this and instead use repeat and say repeat with each. So repeat with the items here. I'm going to click there and say shortcut input, click again, and then say added files like that. And now it's going to repeat through all of the added files for the input. So that's going to repeat through all the added files. Now we want to check to see if each item is a PDF. So I'm going to look for if here, and I'm going to add if here, if condition, if, and I'm going to change this to the file extension. So the file extension of the repeated item is, and then set that to PDF. If it is a PDF, now we'll use move and we'll say move file, move the repeat item to what? Well, we're going to set it to that PDF folder there. So now with this set up, anytime a file is downloaded here that's a PDF, the shortcut should trigger and move it into this folder. Let's test that out by going to this page here at MacMost, and there is actually a download here for a keyboard shortcuts PDF. Let's click on that and download it. And you can see it appeared there briefly in the downloads folder, and then it went into this PDFs folder here. Let's look at it in list view, and we could see it right there. So I'm just scratching the surface here. There are lots of different triggers that you could use, and there are a ton of different actions you can take with the input from those triggers. You can play around and experiment more with shortcuts to see how these automations can help you. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.